Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about new releases from Horror Writers Association authors for November 2020. Now, of course, a lot of these are already out. We're suffering the Halloween hangover, aren't we? Halloween, October, it was all very busy. So a lot of these books have already been released, or you can have in your hands right now. This isn't on the list, but The Low, Low Woods. Now, this comes from Joe Hill's new imprint, Hill House Comics, through DC, and it says Black Label, DC Black Label. This is a gorgeous hardcover edition of this series, The Low, Low Woods. It takes place in Pennsylvania, and I'd like to think it has something to do with Centralia, from Cameron Maria Machado, and that's who wrote it. Danny is who illustrated it, and the colorist is Tamara Bonvillier. And I am very interested to read this. I picked this up as an anniversary gift for me and my husband to share and read. Since we're unable to visit the US, we'll visit the US. I'm looking forward to this. And of course, this Hill House Comics brand new thing, there's another one coming up in the list I'm about to get to. This is a new release I've already mentioned, of course, the Best Horror of the Year, Ellen Datlow. This is volume 12, and it has a lot of really great HWA and other authors. Not everyone is part of the Horror Writers Association, that much is true, but it does count today because it is out. If you haven't ordered your copy already and you're interested, if you like short stories, then this is definitely a go-to and great for the winter months. So now, as mentioned, here are some new releases from Horror Writers Association authors. A lot of these are already out. I'll get all the way through the list, and I think that they are all actually out. So there will be another list at the end of the month, or closer to the end of the month, probably, with things that have come out for the rest of the month or are coming up into the winter months. But for now, like I said, it's all Halloween hangover, right? So this is already out. This came out in the summer. Severed Wings by Stephen Elliott Altman from Wordfire Press. A gothic love story about a young man who is trying to emotionally recover after a car accident that left him paralyzed. Infatuated with his beautiful new neighbors, he ultimately discovers something strange and supernatural. They are Nephilim, cast from the garden on the run from a ferocious demon hellbent to destroy them. I like the sound of that. I myself was also cast from the garden. Burials by Jessica Drake Thomas from Clash Books, and this is out as well, came out in October. What is buried can return. Those who are dead can still speak. A witch can be burned but not silenced. When the abattoir is opened, the dead will rise. Burials is the narrative of those whose voices have been taken away. Murdered women, witches, ghosts. It's about speaking one's truth and using magic to heal or banish, even from beyond the grave. I love when something is so rich in painting a picture but doesn't exactly tell you what it's about. The cover looks really cool, though. This is another cover I like, and I like the sound of this. Roseneath by Dana McSwain comes from Webhouse Publishing, and it is out. Georgia immediately feels a sense of calm within the old walls of Roseneath, attuned to whatever power is flowing through it. Yet, her dream house has a dead child in the attic and a monster in the basement, but she can't tell her husband since she's not sure it's really him anymore. It sounds like a Kelly Martin book, in a way. But yeah, Dana McSwain's Roseneath. Looking forward to that. Dark Was the Night by Angel Lee McCoy. This comes from Wiley Writers and is out already. The horror stories in this collection take you deep into the lives touched by darkness. Herein you'll meet a grandmother with a taste for storytelling, like my grandmother, a little girl caught in a lightning storm, and a medical intern who learns the true meaning of family the hard way. At times gory, very often moody and intense, these tales reveal a truth about our world. Evil exists and love persists. I like the description of this upcoming book, Unknowing, I Sink, by Timothy G. Huguenin. Independent Legions Publishing put this out, and it is out already. Julian finds a summer job cleaning a mansion belonging to Mr. V, an eccentric recluse obsessed with arcane knowledge. The man's grotesque, swollen appearance, caused by an unknown condition that keeps him bedridden, initially disturbs Julian, and those creepy terracotta statues lurking in the shadows don't help to ease his nerves. This next one has a very long title. A Tale of Hell and Other Works of Horror, Stories of Wizards, Werewolves, Serial Killers, Alien Worlds, and the Damned by Phil Slattery. By Slattery Publishing, and it is out already. In this collection of published and previously unpublished stories of horror, Phil Slattery offers a look into the minds of people who perpetrate horrors, from acts of stupidity to cold-hearted revenge, from today to the heart of werewolf trials in France, from the Old West to alien worlds in the distant future. And I really like the idea of werewolf trials in 17th century France. The next is also of interest for those looking to broaden their reading horizons, Anoka, a collection of Indigenous horror from Shane Hawk. This is independently published and is out already. Welcome to Anoka, Minnesota, a small city dubbed the Halloween capital of the world. With his debut horror collection, Cheyenne and Arapaho author Shane Hawk explores themes of family, grief, loneliness, and identity through the lens of Indigenous life. Looking deeper in the description of that book, it looks really up my alley, especially dealing with something called the Halloween capital of the world. The Five Turns of the Wheel from Stephanie Ellis. This comes from Silver Shamrock and is already out. A blend of folk horror and dark fantasy introduces the unholy trinity of Tommy, Betty, and Fiddler. This mummer's troupe leads five nights of bloody ritual in a quiet corner of England, only to be challenged by the women who stand to lose and suffer the most. I had to look up what a mummer's troupe was, and it's just like independent little actors that roam around in a little troupe. A geyser's troupe is another term for it, and they're quite popular, apparently. It's probably what you'd see doing the inexperienced actors doing Shakespeare in the Park and stuff like that. The Pizza Deliveryman's Tale from Ronan, Barbour, and this is from Green Gingerbread Press, and I have an inkling that this may skirt bizarro territory, not just basing this on the cover. A pizza delivery driver is led through a town by a mysterious voice on his smartphone. Is it a matter of time before the malevolent voice interrupting his GPS leads him to the wrong place at the wrong time? What will he do when he comes face to face with Vampire Santa? What will he do indeed? What would you do? What would I do? The real question here is, what would Vampire Santa do? This looks promising and darker, I think, than it promises. Maybe it's lighter than it promises. I always found that with Human Centipede, I found that that was a lot more lighthearted than I had anticipated. Daphne Byrne by Laura Marks, illustrated by Kelley Jones. This comes from DC Comics. Hill House is the imprint. And if you may recall from the beginning, the Lolo Woods, it was the other one that I'd picked up recently from this. And this looks just as beautiful. And it is out this week. In the gaslit splendor of old New York, rage builds inside 14-year-old Daphne. While fighting to free her mother from a group of spiritualist charlatans, Daphne begins to sense a strange, insidious presence in her own body. An entity with unspeakable appetites. What does he want? And could she even stop him if she tried? I wonder how they'll illustrate that. You know, that's really cool sounding. Life Among the Tombstones by H.R. Boldwood. This comes from Third Street Press and is out already. In this prequel to the Corpse Whisperer series, down-and-out zombie hunter Allie Nighthawk returns to her hometown of Cincinnati and finds herself knee-deep in murder, mayhem, and zombies. Can she solve multiple murders when she doesn't know who to trust? And is she strong enough to do the unthinkable when an evil necromancer takes his revenge? And we have The Underclass. This is from Dan Weatherer through Demain Publishing, and it is out this week on the 13th. And I've read other stuff from Demain Publishing, and most notably, there was a book, The Venus Complex by Barbie Wilde. They seem to be really up and coming, and I don't know how long this is. A lot of what they'd put out were these short, sharp shocks, but I believe that they are doing long-form, full book-length books now. The Underclass offers a world where the rules of death suddenly no longer apply. Lee prepares for the greatest day of his largely uneventful life, promotion to the first rung of middle management. However, his afterlife takes an unexpected turn when he is involved in a fatal road traffic accident on his way to work. Last but not least, we have Dollhouse by J.C. Bratton from Blue Milk Publishing, and it comes out next week. I've not heard of Blue Milk Publishing, so I'll be interested to look further into this one. The elaborate handcrafted dollhouse from Japan came with three beautiful dolls, each one identified by name. Little did John know that each doll also came with her own chilling, macabre backstory, presented in a mysterious book sent along with them. And if we're lucky, this will be a three-part anthology read to us via that book. I just finished watching one of my new most favorite anthology horror films, The Mortuary Collection, which is on Shudder. And I mean, I'd have to say that Stephen King, Joe Hill, that combination when Joe Hill was a kid and Stephen King was in the prime of his writing horror, his working, of course, with George Romero, brought us the Creepshow anthology, and that was just so formative to me. Creepshow 2 to a lesser extent as well, because there were stories in there that I always wanted to see on film. And this Mortuary collection has given that a run for its money. It's right up there with Tales from the Dark Side, which I've always had held in a little higher regard. Maybe it's the Debbie Harryness of it all, or maybe it's just that those tales are particularly dark. They're far more dark, I think, than Creepshow ever was. And then you have Trick or Treat, which gets even a little more dark, although it is, you know, has the production value, the higher production value and techniques of this century behind it. It's still kind of old. It's older than I remembered, you know, and we haven't really had something that really hits that high watermark that Creepshow initially set, but now we do. We have the Mortuary collection. I highly recommend seeking that out. It is fantastic. I really enjoyed the hell out of that. And I have got to mention that even though the new Creepshow series, the first run really wasn't for me, there's a new Creepshow out right now that is animated, and it was fantastic. And they actually pulled off animating one of my favorite Stephen King stories, Survivor Type, which I never thought I would see in any way, shape, or form on a screen, and here we are. I remember being young and being disappointed that that Tom Hanks movie with the volleyball wasn't Survivor Type by Stephen King. I don't think that you could really pull that off, but hey, they have, and it's fantastic, so highly recommend that too. So yeah, if you've read any of these new releases, or particularly things from Demain Publishing or Hill House through DC Comics, definitely let me know in the comments below. That'd be super cool. And as ever, thank you for watching and have an ooky spooky day. Now, these are new releases from horror. When he is under the...